The following is a presentation of TFNN. It is now time for the Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Wednesday. And thank you, Steve, for two great hours. Of course, even earlier than that, John came in with a global market overview and actually a very educational program. John Logan sets his sights on explaining the software capabilities, the mathematical possibilities of the different trades, as well as the techniques that he uses and he demonstrates every single day. So 8 o'clock all the way until 6 o'clock, we are right here live discussing our various techniques and explaining what we think is what are the chances of the market moving higher or lower. I mean, it's as simple as that. I'm in the bearish camp. I have to wait for a little bit more evidence because I need the close on the day. But I had mentioned that if the Dow starts trading in the 16,800s, and then leaves the 16,800s as a resistance area, we have set in place a sell mode in the daily chart and the weekly chart. Probably by Friday, if the weakness continues, we'll go into a sell signal. It hasn't even given a sell signal. It's been so strong, and some of the other indices have been really good. Look at the Qs. I mean, the Qs right now are trading at up 13 cents at 96.73. So it's very, this is so fascinating. This is very stock specific. And at the same time, while it's stock specific, it is also very bifurcated. There are stocks that we've been wanting to buy. We just missed them on the long side. We're still long one particular stock that's doing very nicely today, up 1.27% on a day like that, where the market is down 0.42 in the Dow, down 0.21% in the S&P, and that's quite good. And we are short the sentiment indicators as well as the Dow. Now, as far as I'm concerned, this bifurcated market might hold bifurcated for about another few days. But if we close poorly on Friday, next week could see a much greater selling spectrum as more and more stocks join in because of the weekly and even their monthly charts. So let's go through the numbers now. The S&P minis, the minis are down minus 275. They were way up. I mean, there was a single leg A, if you're looking at shorter time frames, that we saw earlier this morning, and that took the E-minis right up to 1974.25. It is now 25 points off that high. That's big. So we've seen that now. This is the second time. Now, what I had spoken to my, well, didn't speak, what I typed for my subscribers to my opening calls, my daily newsletter, very comprehensive look at the markets, giving parameters for all the different important ETFs and for the dollar, the bonds, the TLT, the GLD, the diamonds, the SPY, the Qs, etc. I like to give those parameters. I also like to say this is what we're looking at in the volatility index or anything else that I'm looking at in terms of the sentiment indicators. I also mentioned that with the Fed speak today at 2 o'clock, we could see whippy action. It is after the Fed speak, around about 3 p.m., if certain factors are in place. This is what we can expect from the market, and that's very comprehensive. Look at this right here. This is the daily Dow. I'd drawn this in last week. I'd shown the arch, or even before that, the arch formation, the up channel that became support and then became resistance, the nine-period moving average, the maroon line, left side, right side price time match, which says 16,805 should be reached no later than the 4th of August, that's next week. with a price time match with the inside wedge, which acted as beautiful support the day that Dow went to 16,877 on the 28th. Then it bounced up, trying to push way above the 9-period moving average. Couldn't even close above that yesterday. Closed at the low of the day. And the day you saw that opening, it has just been perfect for trapping the shorts the last week. All the action, the words that have been flowing out here on the different networks, either Bloomberg or CNBC or anything that you can read, is suggesting that there is still much more upside to go. I don't disagree, but on the shorter term, I do disagree very vehemently. Why? Because we've got this Chapman wave inside wedge dashed line. And if you take it out, it says not only is that support making you vulnerable, look, the MACD is expanding its beta, its difference between the 9-period differential, that's the green line going down, and the red, which is the slow moving average. And look at the histogram expanding. Look at the slow stochastic down to the 43% level. Yep, we could get a reversal today, but I think it will be temporary, and we're making a very big arch formation. We have been trading within the black candles, the range. Now we've gone decidedly below it. Even if we go above it for the close today, it says, no, no, no. Keep an eye on this. Lower highs and lower lows. That is the change of trend. So I'm kind of negative, more on the down than anything else, but many of the stocks that we've been looking at wanting to either short or the sentiment indicators. Look at this. The volatility index is at 13.82, up 54 cents in leg E. That could recycle to a brand new A, but I'm calling it E for now. It's above the dashed. This is the wedge. The apex was reached early this morning, and now it's out of that apex to the upside. Usually, when we get a move like this in the cup formation that breaks decidedly above the left side high of 13.64 in this 120-minute chart, you've got to respect that and say, so far, this is showing energy to the upside as selling is intense. And now we've got the 120-minute chart failure in the Dow. That says that resistance there has worked. Now we're looking at our drawdown right now, and you'll see how trend lines, just choosing the right pinpointed, there you are. The trend line to watch will be this trend line here, and says 16,780. 16,780 is going to be a key number in this particular pattern. And look at this. Richard Arm's trend index, the short-term trading index. Nothing. Nothing. It's at 0.80. It hasn't even opened the door to say, hello, everybody, what's happening in the market today? It's still asleep. It must be in, let's see, it must be in, well, San Francisco would be 3 hours behind. No, 8:15. It must be, I don't know, maybe it's out for the day, but it is out to lunch, and that's very important. Not only that, look at these trend lines, just a simple trend line. I'm doing nothing. These are bar charts. Here's the Dow chart. We're breaking underneath this major support level, and the S&P is also breaking under its trend line support. So put that together, and I have to say, I'm looking at the market right now askance. I'm saying, I don't know what that upside action is, because for months I've been saying only when we start to get the volatility index ignoring rallies in the market and any news, whether it's 4% GDP, any news, whether it's good news or bad news, it doesn't matter. What matters is the price relationship to the news. If the price ignores the news and it's good news, that's negative. If the price ignores the news and it's bad news, the market's up, that's a positive. The response is the most important thing. And look at this 120-minute chart of the diamonds with, look at that deflection of the faster moving average, the differential, 9-period differential in the MACD, and the stochastic turning down. Doesn't say you couldn't have a little another pop-up to try to get back into that, what I call the inside track support, but we've broken under the 200-period exponential moving average right at 168.38. We're at 168.18 right now, having hit 167.82. I have to tell you something. Everything that I'm looking at in the market is suggesting that You've just got to be very careful here. Even if there's a Fed-related spike to the upside now by the end of the day, it seems to me that we're in place for at least a digestive period, number one. And number two, it is becoming so selective. Let me show you something. I had this as a short recently, and then we got out. I can't remember if we made a little money or lost a little money, but it was small. And then we left it alone. Well, I wanted to do that exact same thing yesterday and today, and I didn't. Why? Because this is Aetna, Health Insurance Comprehensive Global, leg E in the week, in the monthly, peak E. If this is a peak from last week's high of 85.72, comes out with great news, pops up 2 points yesterday pre-market, then closes down. The only reason why it didn't, for one of the only times I can remember, maybe two, three times in all these hundreds, thousands of charts, did I see an all-time high at a peak C in the daily. There's no other way I could have counted. There is another way I could have counted it, but I didn't want to count it. That would be A, B, C, D, E, F, and that would have been a G. I just wanted to give it time. So we lost a really good entry on a short at all-time highs. You know, I love to try to do that. And that's Aetna AET down 2.91 at 78.99. Let me go to the numbers before I forget. The Dow's up, the Dow's down 60 at 16,851. The S&P's down 2.31. This bifurcation we've seen for weeks now, QQQs have been very good. The IWM, terrible. Today's actually quite good. The Dow has been very weak with my four Dow indicator stocks. GE, that's the shorter-term one, suggesting weakness to come. We've seen that. UTX suggesting intermediate-term weakness to come. We are still seeing that. IBM rallies are now starting to fail, watching it real closely. I think peak E in the daily. And Triple M. Acting as one of the best. Where did I go there? Where did I just type? Let me type here. 1, 2, 3. UTX, peak D in the daily, possible peak F. Now, this could be that pattern in the Chapman way that I call. It's a very subtle thing. It is a two-bar reversal. And that two-bar reversal in the weekly says if on Friday Triple M closes below 142, that would be the first close below the nine-period exponential moving average since the week of April the 11th, when it hit 136, the recent high was 146. This is going to be absolutely fascinating. Leg F, this is the reason why I'm a little bit, I got one foot on the brake and a little toe tap on the pedal for the accelerator, because I'm a little concerned about these monthly charts. I shouldn't be, because the month isn't even close to being finished. Got a couple of days to go, or 2 days to go. But I'm looking at this and I'm saying, this makes me nervous. Okay, so we've got the Dow and the S&P down. We've got the the QQQ series, 1, 2, 3, just before we go to break. The Qs are only down, up 22 cents, making also a potential two-bar reversal in the weekly. We won't know. We'll only know if the Qs begin, so at 96.52, if the Qs start trading in the 95.50 or lower area, at that point we'll finally get the QQQ series negative IWM.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
T TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Investors, Taz Market Research delivers to its subscribers expert commentary on the analysis of 15 different markets each day. Get this invaluable and timely information through the daily market research videos Taz Market Research produces each day before 9 a.m. The video analysis will include reports on currencies, interest rates, indices, metals, energies, grains, and more. You'll be able to gauge where high profitability setups are in each of the markets. Receive a free two-week trial subscription to Taz Market Research videos on the front page of TFNN.com.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
With the launch of Tiger TV, TFNN has brought our programming to the next level. With Tiger TV, you can gain access to each host's charts and computer screens as they host their daily stock program. Whether it's Tom O'Brien, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, David White, Larry Pesavento, Andy Hecht, Victor Jones, or Daryl Martin, you can catch all of our technicians hosting their programs live and archived on Tiger TV for your viewing pleasure 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you haven't checked out Tiger TV, then visit TFNN.com and see what you're missing. Basil takes your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Folks, we're back. So let's continue that. So look at the GCQ14. That is gold. Gold is turning down. And the pattern that I've been discussing for quite some time, I'm going to just go to. So the gold is down 440 at 1293 at this particular point. Let me double check. Yep. So this is going to be very interesting. Why? Because the pattern that I drew in a year ago, I think it was. I don't know how long ago. A long time ago. Yeah, a year ago, exactly. Of the H pattern. Remember, I drew this in. And I said that H pattern, you can go to a continuous M pattern. That's the pattern I think is unfolding in gold. And until gold decisively breaks, the GLD breaks above 134, it's 10 points higher. It's at 124.56 right now. That'll be a big positive if it can do that. Until it can do that, I just think that it is in a trading range. And if you can pick up the trading range, I think you can do very well. But at this particular point, with all the overseas problems and you're seeing nothing in gold, that's very unusual. Look at the SLV. Right here, that's the Silver iShares Trust. Pulling back, made a peak in the Chapman wave. The technicals are failing. It's holding very nicely, but it hasn't been able to rally yet. So gold and silver will follow, but gold very often moves. It's like an overnight thing out of the blue. You get this hysterical flight to safety. Well, flight, I call it the currency of fear, and you get that flight into gold. So at this particular point, having a little bit of gold, I think there's no problem with that. Some of the gold stocks are acting very well. But gold itself, just if there was no news, I'd say gold is just in a trading range and it's probably going down to the lower part of the range. Look at crude oil. Let's see. Just for now, I'm going to go to the continuous contract. Made a peak in the weekly, and this is very important. The pattern that we saw recently, the peak D top that it made, the reason why the letters have moved is this is a continuous contract. It keeps getting smoothed out. If you're really trading, I would not use this other than as a reference point. So if we had to go to, I'm going to go to the Q August. Let's see what, yeah, the August contract is holding very nicely here at 104.42, made a peak D in crude oil on the 25th of June. And that price was 107.50, pulls back to 99.01 on the 15th. Nice rally, but this is that 50% retracing. Going to watch this real closely. It needs to move above 105, I'd say 105.70. It really needs to get above that doji high of 106.09, and then it's going to go all the way back to the recent top. But otherwise, if crude oil starts to slide, 103.70, is the first support. I would just say that at 102.30, it's starting to show a failure pattern. Right now, we don't have anything like that other than the weekly chart says, hey, be careful. This could just be that move to the upside that can fail at any point. So a couple of questions in the den. One was Merck. Merck's been on a tear. It's just been an incredible, incredible mover. If you're looking at the charts, look at this. Left side, right side price time match to, it was last month, and it missed it. 61.62 was the high back in 2007 at peak E. Pulls all the way back to 20, and then it rallies, and it rallies to where? It rallies to 59.32. And then tries to take that out. It goes to 59.65. Oh, that was higher. No, 59.84. So this is a peak C1, C2 in the Chapman methodology. Nothing yet technically bad in the monthly chart. If you go to the weekly chart for Merck, look at that. This is the pattern that always makes me somewhat nervous. You've got yourself a spike to the upside and you come back down. It's like a flagpole pattern, except I treat it very differently in the Chapman wave. Within that, very often you'll get a peak ABCD in a shorter time frame that tries to go from the lows to the high. It goes, the rule is, it tries to go to exactly at or just above the previous high, and then you've got to be careful. Well, it failed just above the previous high, and now it seems to be wanting to turn down. The MACD is negative. Stochastics at 72%. I would venture to say that Merck looks a little bit vulnerable here. If you're a very long-term holder, that's not an issue. But if you're even more intermediate term, I'd be taking off some money right now as we're speaking. Why? Because the pattern that I'm looking at says that the next target is where I've circled right there in the 57s, the low 57s to the high 56s. But if that is taken out within 3 to 5 trading sessions, be careful because you go all the way down to the key support of 56.40. Now, all the way down is short term. If you're in for the long term, a point or two is nothing. There, the support is 55.30 in the monthly chart. So just be somewhat careful here with Merck. If you've got good profits, I'd be taking some money off. I'm not sure I'd be shorting. I don't see right now more than about a point or so. I'll be right back. Basil Chapman, Tiger Technicians out.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization optimization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
Andy Heck's powerful weekly newsletter, the Technomental Commodity Report, has delivered multiple triple-digit winning trades in recent months. And right now's the perfect time to get a full month-long trial to Andy's newsletter with no obligation to pay anything. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you'll lock in the low rate of only $59 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
Daryl Martin coined the phrase diagnostic trading, and we're happy to announce that his diagnostic box spread analyzer has finally been released. The Diagnostic Box Spread Analyzer helps you easily identify the best box spreads on Nadex in seconds, plus you receive access to the diagnostic deviation levels, as well as step-by-step training videos teaching you how to trade Nadex spreads so you can quickly master the mechanics of this simple yet powerful trading instrument. By pulling live data from the Nadex Exchange, the Diagnostic Box Spread Analyzer does all the math for you, calculating risk, reward potential, distance to break even for both outright spreads and spreads used to hedge the underlying market. Visit the front page of TFNN.com today to get your two-week free trial to Daryl Martin's Diagnostic Box Spread Analyzer and gain access to the valuable information it can provide when trading the Nadex Box Spreads.
Who says you can't take it with you? TFNN says you can. With your mobile device and TFNN's live radio streams, TFNN has put it all in the palm of your hands. No special apps to download. No subscription fees for live radio or Tiger TV streams. We say you can.
Now let's go over to the dollar, because the dollar is going to be the generator. It is the generator of basically higher dollar, lower market. And what the dollar has done, and this whole uptrend, folks, has just gone sideways. The way it works, folks, is this.
We say you can. The Tiger Financial News Network. Smart investors and professional traders know you can. TFNN.com. Educating investors. This segment is brought to you by Harmony Gold. For more information, just click the Harmony Gold banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks, we're back. Basil Chapman, Tiger Technicians Hour, and let's see. Dow's down 63, S&P's down 2. That was very interesting. Once again, we've got the Dow a lot weaker than the others, but it isn't just that it's weaker. It, in fact, is, I think, acting as a drag to many of the other indices. So when you're looking at the GDX, a question, just a statement in the den, the GDX Market Vectors Gold Miners ETF, look at the daily. You remember the pattern that I spoke about just now that we were talking about in the weekly, was it the weekly chart, where I said there's the H pattern that could become a continuous M pattern. This is a pattern that we've seen before. We saw it in the GLD in the monthly chart. Patterns repeat. Remember, they are just fractals of our human emotion, and they get repeated over and over and over again. Look, there's that H that goes to an M, lowercase h, to lowercase m. If, in fact, the GDX does take out 2595, it says be careful, 2575 is the next support. If that's taken out, then you're looking at 2543 as the next support. That means that any move to the upside has to decidedly take out the upside of 2714 to 2706 to 2714, close above it. The moment it does that, all of a sudden you've got another pattern that says, hey, I've either got a rectangle or this is a little bit too long for it, another kind of a U-shaped cup pattern. So this is the way I'm looking at it right now. Three fighting patterns, two are negative, one's positive, and the only way it's going to be positive is a decisive close above that peak of 2712. So that's the GDX at this particular point. Spectacular move in the weekly. Just went straight from the 22 area to the 27, almost 28 area, 27 to 78 area. So this is a digestive phase, but the 9-period moving average at 2596 is going to be very, very important. So let me do a couple of other things here. I said that I would talk about the volatility index. No, before I do that, let me just finish up. So the DXY, remember yesterday, a few days ago, I was talking about the dollar, and I said, whoa, it broke out. This is very positive. I like what I'm seeing in the dollar. Yesterday, I said, I'm now with Tommy O'Brien talking about King Dollar. I think that the dollar is at this point. Lee is one. This is one of the first times, and I don't know how long, that I've actually called it a very positive move, other than a shorter-term trade. This, to me, might have legs. Let me explain what I mean by legs. In the monthly chart, it's going to have to go at from 81.49 on the index. Let's see, the contract itself is trading at, where did it disappear to? I can't find it right now. All right, well, at this particular point, the dollar is up 27.81.56. All right, the continuous contract, the index itself, dollar DXY is how I get it. He's saying, look, it alternates in a sine wave movement between the arch and the cup. Never the twain shall meet. And look, it's once again making that cup formation as the MACD finally is trying to turn up and maybe will cross positive. But the stochastic has gone right back above 20. It's at 20.67. And the weekly chart is acting extremely well in a decisive cup formation above all the recent resistance levels. The last one was at 81.48 back on the 8th of November of 2013. Here we are at 81.49. So that says this candle right here, the ugly candle of September of 2013, you remember that one? Wow, it came down quickly. 82.31 high, 81.36 low. We're now just into that candle, and then that high will be absolutely significant. Will it make it above 82.67? So in the meantime, back at the ranch, stochastic is good, not great in the weekly, but the MACD is very strong, and the histogram is improving a lot. So I like it. Is it a little extended in the daily? Could this be a Chapman wave? They are inside, inside a restart. And in fact, what we're looking at here is that there is a good chance, because it was so mild, that it could go to a G and maybe not a D. And that would say we've got another couple of days to go before the dollar has a pullback. But in the meantime, back at the ranch, what we're really looking at is this action has gone above the 9-period moving average of 80.98, trading at 81.45. That is about the most that it's been, except for that big spike to peak G, what I call the rogue wave, back on the 5th of June, where it opens at 80.66, spikes to 81.02, and then closes way down at 80.37, just off the low. So I'm watching this really closely in the sense that there's, how can I put it? Because new listeners might not be able to put it together in the Chapman wave methodology. As long as the green line, this fast-moving average of the MACD, is very strong like this, without even acknowledging that little tiny peak D over there, you can expect that we should go to at least a G. It might not be an instant restart with an entire A, B, C, D to the upside. I just don't know. I think it's going to turn into that. And the reason why I think so is because I'm real close to getting a sell mode in the Dow, which is going to drag all the other indices down. That's number one. And, you know, Tom often says, when the dollar goes up, the market tends to go down. It hasn't been that way for a little while, but this could be the very time that it does it. Look at the EUR, USD, the euro-dollar currency pair, breaking down the exact opposite. The nine-period moving average in the weekly is now a strong resistance at 1.353. It's trading under the 200-period moving average. The monthly chart snuck above the very long term. You know, I'm never impressed with these very long term trend lines. They look good while they're working, but in fact, very often they work only momentarily. Because look at this, we're about to retest that major pink downtrend support line. So this is looking at like a peak F top in the monthly. That says that the dollar will have room to go. And look at the USD JPY. USD JPY is the dollar Japanese yen currency pair is holding the 9-period moving average in the monthly, and the weekly chart is breaking out. This is going to be, is this brand new? I'm calling this a sub A, leg A, and a sub leg B because it didn't break the low bar. I'll double check in a second. I don't believe it broke the low bar. So that low bar is 100.749, and we went to 100.816. So this is like, this is the pattern that might have an overlapping wave. You remember the pattern I was talking to you about, the GDX? This is the same sort of thing. Is this one successful so far? Because it's trying to break above the arch high. If it goes above 104.121, the high of the week of April the 4th of this year, that says, hey, I'm probably going to try to go to that peak C and have an overlapping wave. That would be very positive. And look at this, daily. Oh, my goodness, that is a whopping move. So that means the FXY, I wonder if I've got it all notated. Yeah, made a peak, you know, FXY made a peak D, and it's plummeting. Look at that. It's taking out its low. Whoa, that is very impressive action. So, I would say USD JPY interesting is along for sure. So now let's go to Mike in Denver. Mike, how are you?
Great, sir. How are you doing?
Very well, thank you. You'd like to look at?
Gentex, GNTX.
Okay, so this is GNTX trading at 29.05. It is up 6 cents. Tell me what you're doing.
Well, I was just looking for an entry point. I'm not sure if it is distribution and then going to head down to maybe $15 or if it could be another base waiting to make its next move up.
Those are exactly the points that I would have been talking about. So you've pinpointed exactly what the issue is here. It's stuck in the middle of, not in the middle of the range, in the lower part of a range that it's been in many times before. I'm just trying to check here. 29.09 twice. So that's a phantom peak. I'm going to call it a B and change the color to red. So, folks, we're looking at a number of charts over the past couple of days when I've been getting calls with stocks that have had quite a big move to the downside, come off the bottom, and the big question is, have they started, especially if you're thinking Chapman Wave, have they started a brand new buy mode with maybe leg A, expecting a B, C, and D, or is this just merely a bounce before it goes to retest the lows and probably takes out the most recent lows. Now, there's a pattern that I call the falling axe in the Chapman wave. It's where you get lower highs and much lower lows, and it creates two expanding like a wedge on that side or an ice cream cone on the side. I call it the falling axe because there's usually a long handle. There's the handle, and then the blade is turning down. If the price succeeds in breaking above the trend line resistance, in this case, it would have to be somewhere around 29.39, let's call it 29.45, and hold, it'll tackle the 29.50 loss out of the 24th of July of this year. If it's able to break above that, suddenly you've got a pattern that says, whoa, V-shaped formation or a cup formation. Until then, the weight of evidence says that the MACD, while could be very good if it turned positive, could in fact deflect lower. And the stochastic is not showing the kind of strength it showed when it rallied in June, mid-June. That stochastic was beautiful as the price ran up. So let's do another thing. Let's look at the weekly chart. Now, the pattern that I've been talking about all morning is the pattern that says you've got a sharp move to the downside. Let's just do that. Within that, you've got a kind of a rectangle formation, and it's very nicely. I love when you outline it like a flagpole. You outline where the actual flag should be. But within this, you've got an H pattern that's going to an M pattern. So my immediate answer to you is, I don't see why I would be wanting to go long a stock that's gone A, B, C, D, perfect P, D in the monthly chart, pulls back, has now not been able to find any real strength to break back above the 9-period moving average in the monthly chart as the technicals are starting to weaken. I'm going to make the suggestion, why don't you keep it on your watch list and you'll save a lot of money. And I'll tell you why. Because if it's acting very well today, it's up 8 cents at 29.06 when the market is generally very weak, most of the market is. But I'm not sure I see much more than a pop-up. So as a quick trade to in this market, to take the risk of buying something where the limit is 29.50 and you're at 29.05, that 40 cents, 45 cents, maybe a 1%, maybe a 2% gain, I just don't think it's worth the risk that if the market starts to deteriorate, this could very quickly start to slide under 28.80. And then it's got that H pattern, wants to go down further. So, Mike, I'm going to make the suggestion, keep it on your watch list. If it does rally and it goes above 29.40 by Monday or Tuesday, I'm totally wrong. It's got inner strength. That's going to be a big positive. And then on the next pullback, I would say to you, probably that's the time to get in because it's now up near the resistance area. But I'm going to have to take the risk right now of saying to you, I like the action on the intraday. Maybe if the market was up, it would be doing much better. Mm-hmm. But I'm going to make the suggestion that it's just the only way I would do it is to start a small position. And if it succeeds and it breaks above 29.33, at 29.34, I'd add another trading position, and I'd have a trading stop.
Okay, sounds good. Can you time check one more?
Give me the name, and I'll see if I can do it.
It's CHGG is the symbol.
CHGG. GG. I don't think I've ever looked at this stock. CHGG. Chegg.
Yeah.
Chegging. What does Chegg do?
Not really sure right offhand. I just ran across it in one of my scans.
Yeah, as a scan, I can see that a scan would pick it up as a stock that is rallying after a pullback. So I like it. So it's at 6.30. It's down 4 cents. Doesn't sound like much, but that is 0.63% because it's a low-price stock. Chegg Inc. What I would... You know, I also do scans, and I look at these small stocks, and sometimes I pick them up, and sometimes I don't. Let me just do one right now. I just want to see something, if this one came up in my scan. How would I play this right now? I like the technicals. I like everything about it. I like the fact. I don't like the deepness of the correction from the 8.11 area back in the week of the 27th of June, pulling back to all the way down to 5. That's a deep retracement. Let me just show you something while we're doing this. Let me go to AK Steel. See, this is different. This is a low price stock, but it's making higher highs and higher lows. It's in the steel sector. And X, look at that. We had X. Oh, this is so upsetting to see. We had US Steel way back at 20, I don't know what it was, number of times we've had it, and we didn't hold on, and it's trading right down 32.79. See, this is that bifurcated market. The steel stocks are doing well. Give me a second. I'm going to look at your stock a little closer. As soon as I get back, we've got Mike, and we're holding on. The Dow's down 82, S&P's down 4.5.
Thanks.
Hold on.
You
you take a hands-on approach to managing your investments. And whether you're bullish or bearish on U.S. Treasuries, the ETFs from Direction Shares are there to help you magnify your perspective. Bull ETFs for a rising market and bear ETFs for a falling market. Direction Shares gives you the tools for both sides of the trade. Discover how we can help at DirectionShares.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction Shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction Shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction Shares at 800-851-0511. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors employing dynamic strategies. Investors in the funds should understand the consequences of seeking daily investment results, understand the risk of shorting, and intend to actively monitor and manage their investments. Distributor, Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of the Money Master Show at TFNN.com. Eastern legend tells of a fair maiden who was offered a rare gift by the king of the land, a bag of pearls. The king promised that she could keep the largest, most perfect pearl she could find with these three conditions. 1. Choose only one pearl. 2. Remove one pearl at a time, accept or reject it. And 3. If rejected, it would be lost forever. She began by looking at the pearls, passing on many special treasures. She delved deeper into the bag, and soon the pearls were replaced with pebbles. Sadly, she went home empty-handed. Folks, replace pearls with time, because we cannot go back even 2 seconds. We live in the eternal moment of now. So when now are you going to take advantage of my offer to you, a subscription to my daily investment newsletter service, Mastering Probability, where you can experience the most incredible pearls for trading and investing, the Rhodes Momentum Indicator and Strategy. The offer? It gets better. A 30-day money-back guarantee. Don't go home empty-handed. Mastering Probability. Available on the homepage of TFNN.com.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Backtech Environmental. For more information, just click the Backtech banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
He's at almost 5, and we've got Mike in Denver. We're looking at GNTX, but now we're looking at CHGG, which is Chegg Inc. Of course, they didn't have a chance during the break, so I was busy charting away, so I don't know what they do. But it's in leg B in the daily in a retracement. But I did a little work on the 120-minute chart, and the 120-minute chart says probably it's best to wait. Let's see how 6.21 holds. If it breaks under that, I wouldn't want any part of it. But in the next 2 days, if it actually holds, and even if it attempts to make a new high, then I'd say this is worth at least a trade, a small position in a trade, but I would definitely have a tight stop. So, Mike, I'm going to suggest that the market might be more important right now than individual stocks. There are some that are holding well. Facebook's holding well, a couple of others. But I'm going to say hold off on the long side just for now. Give it a day or two to see how it settles in. It is looking quite good, but that big decline from the 8 level in the weekly chart says it's worth holding off. I hope that helps you.
Sure does. I appreciate your information.
Thank you for calling. Always appreciate it. That was Mike in Denver. And let's go now to the market. It just flashed across the screen. Goodyear Tire. I've been watching this so closely. Why? Because I wanted this as a short for my subscribers. It went right up against the inside track resistance area. It went to a peak D. It made a two-bar reversal the other day, 28.70 high. The next day it was 28.66, 4 cents later. Then it makes the silent Joe, a little doji candle. Then it was negative yesterday. And then it was off my list. I just forgot about it. I'm not sure I would have shorted it, but all the signs were there to say, hey, this could be a peak D in the daily. This could turn out to be a peak E in the weekly, a triple top, slightly rising highs, and the monthly is in leg E. You can see why I'm getting a little nervous about this market. So many stocks have very clearly said that the bar that we're in can't be recycled. It's either an E or an F, so please be careful. Goodyear Tire, telling us a little bit about maybe the auto industry slowing down. We're going to be watching this. So you've got Larry Pesavento coming up. Should be a wonderful show with Larry, as always. Always love watching the Gartleys and the butterflies, the way he interprets them. So let's go to this right now. You've got the volatility index. I'll just make it as simple as I've tried to make it over all the years that I've been doing this. If the volatility index, which right now looks like it's running sharply at 13.19, we've seen this picture before because what happens by the end of the day, it gives it all back. But it's over the 13.49 200 period exponential moving average. It is saying I've got selling pressure, intense selling pressure. And if I break that trend line right there by the end of the day, it's 14. If I go to 14.20 or higher, by the end of the day, tomorrow could be quite a poor day in the market. I've also got that very long wick candle from last week. 1538 is the number to watch from Friday. I break above it. That's the VIX index break above it. Not only am I breaking the downtrend resistance, but it says target of 1722 in August is possible. So these are the levels to watch. If it fails and all of a sudden the VIX is trading back under $12.50, don't worry, folks, you can keep buying because it's just another one of those failures. I don't think this time it's going to do that. It's looking over waves. What's this? VIX, before you end the show, less gasoline use. What happened? We'll get another chance. Yeah, okay. So that's what I'm looking at. Now let me just quickly go to a couple of things that we need to be aware of. I'm using the Dow again. In the Dow, look at this, you're breaking. If that support on a closing basis of 16,805 goes, close underneath that today, that's very negative action. That will impact the weekly. And by Friday, I'm pretty sure I'm going to be getting a sell signal in the weekly if it's underneath 16,870. Stay tuned. You've got Larry Pesavento coming up. I will not be here for live tomorrow's show. And have a wonderful, wonderful day.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
This is TFNN.